Friends, let's discuss a very basic topic of pharmacology, that is pharmacokinetics. Now, the word kinetics, it means movement or motion. So the term pharmacokinetics, it means the movement of the drug inside the body. Okay, so or in other terms you can say what the body does to the drug. So for for a drug to do some action on the body or to cause some effect, it has to reach its site of action. Okay, but we do not give the drug directly into the site of action most of the times. Most of the times the drug is given at some different site and it reaches its site of action by means of various processes. And then its action is terminated by means of another set of processes. So that is all which is encompassed under this pharmacokinetics. So there are, you can divide pharmacokinetics into four processes. One is absorption. Okay. Second process is distribution. Third is metabolism, and fourth is excretion. So we will be discussing pharmacokinetics under these four headings. Okay, so a brief about all these processes. Absorption is the journey of the drug from its route and the site of administration to the bloodstream or to the systemic circulation. Till this point, all the processes involved, they are covered under absorption. Okay. Second is distribution. Distribution is now from the bloodstream when the drug distributes into the tissues, moves out of the bloodstream into the tissues, which also include its site of action. So that is distribution. After that comes the process of metabolism. In metabolism, the drug is transformed into something which is ineffective, which does not act like the drug. Okay, so which is, you can say it is inactivated in a way. And the fourth is removal of that drug from the body. So these are the four processes under which we will be discussing pharmacokinetics. So I will take all of them one by one. So I'll start with absorption. Now, absorption is, as I said earlier, it is the processes involved in taking the drug from its site of administration to the systemic circulation. Okay, now you know, when we have to take a medicine or a drug, it can be taken by various routes. In various ways we can take a drug. We can apply it on the skin, okay, or we can put eye drops or ear drops, or we can ingest a tablet, or we can inject the drug directly. Okay, so there are various routes of administration, and ultimately the drug, it has to reach the systemic circulation. Okay, so whatever the route of administration, the drug will have ultimately to reach the systemic circulation. If it has to, if its site of action is somewhere in the body. If you are using it for a local purpose, say for the skin or some other purpose, then it may not even reach the systemic circulation. It will have its effect at that site only, maybe on the skin or in the eyes or in the ears. Okay, but mostly it has to reach the systemic circulation for causing its effect. So this absorption, whenever it, you know, the most common route of administration is oral. So you ingest the medicine, take the medicine, just like food. So when we take the medicine, the same processes which are involved in absorption of food from the gut, they apply to drugs also. Okay, so you know, in the gut there are various sites where absorption of food occurs. Similarly, absorption of drugs also occurs at similar sites. So one site is the stomach, then another site is the intestine. Intestine is the main place where most of the absorption occurs. So these are the two main sites where actually absorption of food as well as drugs occurs. Stomach is a minor source, minor region, while the intestine is a large region which leads to most of absorption of most of the drugs as well as most of the food. Okay, so now wherever there is absorption, there has to be a passage through the membranes. This is important. So everywhere, whenever when it has to cross from the gut into the endothelial lining and then to the capillaries, the walls of the capillary, the endothelium of the capillaries, then into the bloodstream, so it has to cross through membranes. So there are some factors which affect the absorption of various drugs, and since it involves the passage through membranes, there are various factors which are helpful or which can hinder the movement of drug across the membranes. Okay, so if we talk about the membrane, it is a lipid bilayer with hydrophilic heads and hydrophobic tails. So this bilayer, this is the hydrophilic region, and inside of the membrane is a hydrophobic zone. Now since the inside of the membrane, the in between part is hydrophobic, it does not allow the lipid insoluble or water soluble substances to move through it. Okay, so for easy movement of a drug or a molecule across the membrane, it has to have at least one property, that is, it should be lipid soluble. So when it is lipid soluble, it can easily pass through this lipid bilayer into the inside of the cell. Okay, this is one thing. Another thing is, obviously, the molecule has to be a small molecule. If it is a small molecule, it can easily pass through. If it will be a larger molecule, it will not be able to move as easily as a smaller molecule. So, one, two factors. One factor is lipid solubility. Another thing is size, which should be small, a smaller size. Then it should be non-polar, non-polar moieties, they pass very easily. Then it should be unionized. If the molecule is unionized, it will very easily pass through the membrane, otherwise it will not be able to. Then there should be a good concentration gradient, which always will be there, because the body does not have any drug and we are providing a lot of drug in the gut, so it will be easily there will be a concentration gradient, because the inside of the cell will be having no drug and the lumen will be having a lot of drug, so there will be one force which is moving, which is taking that drug into the cells. Okay, so mostly this absorption of drugs is a passive process. Okay, if it has to be through the lipid bilayer, carrier mediated transport may also be there, like facilitated diffusion can also be seen at various sites. So the important things I have discussed: the agent should be lipid soluble, it should be a small molecule, it should be non-polar, unionized.